So we're here with Tim Toon from WBAL in Baltimore, and you have a unique experience here at NABJ because you brought your son, who is also an aspiring journalist. Can you talk a little bit about that father-to-son dynamic in the industry and some of the things he'll have to look out for as he moves towards a career?
I recall being his age and how much I didn't know about the business. He's interested in sports. I said to him, it's a father-son trip. So I actually got on a plane with him. We came to Orlando, and I got a chance to put him in the right position. I realized that all my career I've talked about what I've done. And to have him now say, Dad, I want to do it, I brought him here to say, okay, here are the people you need to meet. Here's what you want to do. And so it's been fulfilling to watch him get it and also to carry on this legacy of journalism.
You've been a working journalist, an award-winning journalist. You've been a teacher of the craft. What does a conference like this do for you in those two elements of your practicing of journalism?
It really, again, puts me in a place that I recall what it was like when I was the age of most of these students. So I feel like, in fact, when I first got here, someone said to me, a student, sir, is this your first conference? I said, do you see my hair? And I realized that my coming here, I feel like kind of the big brother, kind of the mentor, and I love that role. But I see young people who are hungry, they're smiling, they're excited. It lets me know that the business is still rolling and that with African Americans in particular, they're still finding their place in this. I'm not retiring. Mm-hmm. I'm really enjoying doing this, but it really is fulfilling to see persons hungry and they have the kind of integrity and training that I really like that maybe we didn't have years ago, is they're doing it right.
This is a homecoming of sorts for you. You're a Florida native. You're here in Orlando. Talk about being back home of sorts to participate in this conference. And with all of the news kind of swirling around Florida, what are some of your feelings or thoughts on that?
Well, I grew up north of here, a little place called Live Oak, very small town. Our first trip was to visit mom and grandma and then drive around the state so I could tell my son about where I've grown up. Being in Orlando, but being a Florida native outside the state and hearing what's happened in Sanford, I could relate to that. And by the same token, I don't want to put my state down. What happens in Florida happens all over the country, but I feel a special place that I know people in the state. I have family here. I have nephews here. I have nieces here. That's so important. And I feel strong feelings about people getting along, but it's not just a Florida problem. It's everywhere.
Final thought. You talked about the journalists that are coming of age now and they're doing it right. What do you think is the one thing that the journalist of tomorrow is going to have to learn from today and yesterday to be productive and responsible not only to the craft but to the black community at large?
Getting it right. The thing I learned before I could have my broadcasting voice was to make sure I could write and to tell a story and to be fair. And that's so important, is that no matter how big or small the story is, you got to get it right. And you got to be fair. And storytelling hasn't changed. I run the gaps with some of the early founders of NABJ, and I'm proud to say that we're still talking about doing it right. And I always tell kids, you got to work hard, twice as hard. And that's so important to me. And I still do it every day. I sit down at my computer, same thing. I practice what I preach.